you want to attend a council meeting, it's one of the reasons you receive that paper with all of the Zoom connects, council. So if you ever want to be a part of a council meeting, you are most welcome to be there. Now, I don't know if this can happen. The first hymn really ought follow confession, right? Is that how we have it?
Well, in here we have it, the first hymn first, then the confession, but
right.
You want to try to move that?
Yeah, can we flip that? Because that's how it's supposed to be.
Okay. Why don't you go ahead and start with the confession of forgiveness? And
we'll do that, okay. The two other things, just so you know, I'm typically background in the church. I've been having issues with that ability to do that. So what you see is my dining room in the family room. And until that computer issue gets figured out, as far as that goes. And also, this comes from Bonnie. Many, many thanks to Wendy Costanza for her time with Faith Builders. This was going to be her last teaching year. It's a heck of a way to end a year, but many, many thanks for her time and dedication over the years for working with the young people of St. Andrews. Okay. So, thank you. David reminded me, Bible study starts this week, Wednesday. That information is on that sheet as well. Wednesday, not at 6:30, but at 7, an hour and a half, 7 to 8:30. If you have any interest, please join us. If you need materials, please let me or the that happen. Okay, worship now continue, or we prepare ourselves for worship, I should say, with the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose steadfast love is everlasting, whose faithfulness endures from generation to generation.
Amen.
Trusting in the mercy of God, let us confess our sin. Reconciling God, we confess that we do not trust your abundance, and we deny your presence in our lives. We place our hope in ourselves and rely on our own efforts. We fail to believe that you provide enough for all. We abuse your good benefit. We fear difference and do not welcome others as you have welcomed us. We sin in thought, word, and deed. By your grace, forgive us. Through your love, renew us. And in your spirit, lead us. So that we may live and serve you in newness of life.
Amen.
Beloved of God, by the radical abundance of divine mercy, we have peace with God through Christ Jesus, through whom we have obtained grace upon grace. Our sins are forgiven. Let us live now in hope, for hope does not disappoint. Because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. And now, Eternal Father, strong to save.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Let us pray. Almighty Creator and ever-living God, we worship your glory, eternal three in one, and we praise your power, majestic one in three. Keep us steadfast in this faith, defend us in all adversity, and bring us at last into your presence, where you live in endless joy and love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
The first reading is from the book of Genesis, chapter 1 to chapter 2. A reading from Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and the darkness covered the face of the deep. While a wind from God swept over the, then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness night. And there was evening, there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called this dome sky, and there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruits, trees of every kind on earth that bear fruit with the seed in it." And it was so. The earth, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening and there was morning the third day. And God said, "There be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them be the signs and for seasons and for days and years. And let there be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made the two great lights and the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night. And the stars, God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good, and there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures fly above the earth, across the dome of the sky. So God created the great sea monsters and every living creature that moves of every kind with which the waters swarm and every winged bird of every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful and multiply and fill the waters in the seas and let birds simply multiply on the earth." And there was evening and there was morning the fifth day. And God said, "Let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things, and wild animals of the earth of every kind." And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. And then God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said, be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it, and have domain over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. God said, see, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit, you shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food, and it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed, it was very good. For there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were filled too. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that he had done, and he rested on the seventh day from all the work that he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work that he had done in creation. These are the generations of the heavens and the earth when they were created. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 8 will be spoken responsively. O Lord our God, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
You whose glory is chanted above the heavens out of the mouths of infants and children, you have set up a fortress against your enemies to silence the foe and avenger.
When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars you have set in their courses.
What are mere mortals that you should be mindful of things, that you should care for them?
Yet you have made them little less than divine. With glory and honor you crown them.
You have made them rule over the works of your hands. You have put all things under their feet.
All flocks and cattle, even the wild beasts of the field.
The birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatever passes along the paths of the sea.
O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
The second reading is from 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 11 to 13, a reading from 2 Corinthians. Paul writes, finally, brothers and sisters, farewell. Put things in order. Listen to, agree with one another. Live in peace, and the God of love, peace, will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the saints greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 28th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshiped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. Remember, I am with you always to the end of the age. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Well, a lot has changed since last Trinity Sunday. Not just the COVID-19 pandemic under which we live, but also the killing of George Floyd, an unarmed, handcuffed black man, by a white police officer in Minneapolis. Just a few weeks ago, we learned, many of us, of the shooting of Ahmaud Arbery. But since that time, Breonna Taylor, Dejan Sean Reed, Tony McDade have also been killed. And how many others whose names are known only to their families and to God? Today is Trinity Sunday. It's a hard holiday for us to wrap our minds around. It's a difficult concept. But we learn about the Trinity, particularly in today's first lesson from Genesis. In this beautiful song of creation, we hear, in the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. And a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. And God said, and creation began. Martin Luther put it this way: so also the Christian church agrees that in this description, there is indicated the mystery of the Holy Trinity. Father created through the Son, whom Moses called Word, and over this creative work brooded the Holy Spirit. Later, God says, let us make humankind in our image. This is the glorious relationship with God that spills out into all creation. God is not a lone ranger, and all of God shows up. All of God shows up, delighting in creation, caring for creation, weeping for creation, redeeming creation. I confess that I do not fully understand or even have language to describe the mystery of the Trinity. Probably won't until I finish my baptismal vocation and stand in the presence of God. I can't explain how, but I can testify to the great Lutheran question, what does this mean? God is relationship. Within God and flowing from God. Creation is God's decision not to look after God's self, but focuses God's energies on creation. This Trinity, this God, this relationship is outward and overflowing. God is the one who does not grasp. As we hear in Philippians, let this same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as a thing to be grasped. Likewise, the Spirit is poured out on us all. Again, what does this mean? God is relationship within God, with the creation, with humankind, and among humankind. And since we are baptized into the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, baptized into the Trinity, we are also part of this powerful, dynamic, living, giving, loving relationship with God, in God, with creation, with each other. We are inextricably woven together. No one is alone. No one is beyond the fierce, tender love of God, and God is not far off. God is present in creation, in each of us and in all of us. God is flesh and blood made visible in Jesus of Nazareth and in every human being. God is spirit, closer than our own breath. And this is how God as Trinity shows up today. God is creator. God created diversity, beautiful, vital, alive. We must reject calls for color blindness. That diminishes and washes out God's gift of diversity. We in the white majority can begin to see our siblings of color more clearly. We should be color amazed, recognizing the strength that comes with all our many colors. And God is creator, made all of us in God's image. Let us make them in our image. That means all of us are a part of this relational triune God who did create all of humankind, each and every one, and all of us together in God's image, all. And God is the Word made flesh, our flesh, your flesh, my flesh, George Floyd's flesh. Jesus in his passion still suffers with those who suffer. The crucifixion of an unarmed, handcuffed man lying face down on the street is the crucifixion and the passion of our Lord. The crucifixion of so many, too many, Black and brown people who live constantly with the violence of racism is the passion of our Lord. And God is spirit. The wind, the breath that moved over the face of the deep at creation, the breath of God that was breathed into the first earth creature, Adam. The breath of Jesus as he gave them the gift of the Spirit. The breath crushed out of George Floyd. The breath of life God had given to him. And now, church, we as the baptized, those of us baptized into the Trinity, show up. We work for an end to violence. The violence of racism that kills bodies and maims souls. And we work for the end of violence brought about by lawlessness and also frustration, masquerading in some cases as protest. In the fierce love of the Trinity, we do not deny anger. In the face of the reality and inequity of racial injustice, anger is appropriate. But we use our anger to bring about change. We put out fires set to stores, workplaces, churches, and property. But we ask that the Spirit kindle in us the fire of justice. We work for calm and quiet throughout our country, but we remain disquieted as we search deep within ourselves. We work for peace, but not the passive peace that allows the mechanisms of racism and white supremacy to stay in place. No, the peace God alone can give, that gives us the strength and courage to act. The Trinity is a relationship within God, with creation, with us, and among us. Until the white majority feels in our soul that the pain and suffering of Black and brown people is our own pain and suffering, it will not be safe to be Black or brown in America. And until we feel in our own soul that this is our pain and our story, we are not open to the relationship that God wants to shower, share, lavish upon us as a relational God, a loving God, as a God of the Trinity, as a God who has brought us into that relationship and commands us to share that relationship and live that relationship with creation and with each other. Paul's second letter to the Corinthians ends, "The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all." It's actually a promise, and I think marching orders for us. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ is with us. The love of God is with us. The communion of the Holy Spirit is with us. And together, in the communion and community of the Holy Trinity, we can make that a reality. Amen.
Our service continues with by using the our confession of faith, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Peace of Christ
be and also with you.
Now we'll have the anthem. Thank you.
called into the unity with one another and the whole creation, let us pray for our shared world.
God of community, you form us as your church. Guide our bishops, pastors, deacons, and all the baptized in sharing your life-giving good news with all the world. Strengthen us to be bold in our proclamation. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of creation, you called everything into being. Sustain this world with your renewing care. Inspire us to see waterways, plant life, birds, fish, and call that good. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of counsel, all authority belongs to you. Encourage the leaders of this and every land to seek peace, equality, and unity. Instill wisdom in the advocates who work towards justice in often ignored communities. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of care, you created us in your image. Help us see your likeness in one another. Open our eyes to see and attend to all who face oppression and suffering. Console, heal, and nourish all in need, especially Doreen, Pastor Dufresne, Diane, Sue, Sean, Shirley, Pam, Ruth, Melissa, Jim, Corey, Marlon, Jean, Jerry, David, and those we now name silently in our hearts. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for the Northeastern Pennsylvania Synod and the Reverend Dr. Samuel R. Zeiser, Bishop. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of companionship, you accompany this body of faith. As the rhythms of summer begin, protect all who travel, renew all who will enjoy a time of Sabbath, and shelter all who will not be protected from the sun's heat. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of compassion, you comfort us in our grief with the promise of the resurrection. We give you thanks for all the saints of all time and in our lives. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. Heavenly God, we do pray for those who have been affected by this pandemic we call COVID-19. We pray that end to this pandemic and that you would also care for those who have been affected by it. We pray for those on the front lines, especially we name Cindy, Nick, David, Joe, Jim, Linda, and those who we name before you. We pray for those who have come down with the virus. We pray for those, dear God, who work with those who are ill. Pray for all those who have been affected in any way. Dear God, bring your healing power of love. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for peace in our country and in your world, dear God. We pray for your justice to come from a violent, come together as a people and find good and peaceful ways to be together. Dear God, bring us your peace. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We pray for all of those who are in the pathways of Tropical Storm Cristobal. We pray, dear God, that you would keep them safe, that you would protect them from the winds and the water. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Dear God, receive these prayers and those too deep for words. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus. God the Creator, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, bless you and keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Amen.
And now let's finish the service with hymn number 413, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty.
Go in peace. Christ is with you.
Thanks be to God.